Hi guys, today I thought I'd do a video about websites getting defaced. So it's been a really long, I mean, really long time since I had any of my servers get compromised or so this is kind of like a tutorial on websites that are vulnerable to getting defaced, not just because the server was hacked, but because you're running like a post or a blog that accepts comments or users' feedback, and they just put in like unrequested information or solicitation about selling drugs or putting bad words in there or just things you don't want on your site, right? See, there's tools you can use that will monitor if your site is getting defaced or has invalid content on it. So today I thought I would just go ahead and do a tutorial on checking your web pages. So you can put a website that gets checked regularly and see if it's getting defaced or any information is not that you don't want on there. So I remember hearing about security exploits in the past, about websites, and you hear like government websites eventually sometimes getting defaced by hackers. So that's kind of one instance where this tool might come into play, where if you use it to monitor, so if some of your server did get compromised and some activist group is trying to make a statement on some military or government site, this tool would check for that. If it's your own company site and some hackers, they're just trying to get in there just to, prove that they can sometimes. So just putting like their little trademark or their little, signature on your main page is going to be how they advertise that they just hacked into your server. So really you're kind of checking for that. So today I'm just going to go over how quickly you can go ahead and set it up and monitor and check for keywords on your website to make sure it has not been defaced. So the first thing you want to do is I'm going to log into my Nagios XI interface, and I'm going to be using a Nagios plugin that checks for web content on a page, shows checking the status. So this is a fresh install, and I'll put a link here if you're not familiar with Nagios XI. I'll put a link here on how to get started on configuring Nagios XI server and a client. So right now, when you do the initial server install, you're just going to have one client being monitored, and that host is the local host. So it's the same server that Nagios is installed in, it's the one that's monitoring. So by default, that's there with any brand new installation. So we're going to want to add a second host, and this is going to be our web server. So we're going to want to check, right, the port 80 and 443 for HTTP and HTTPS traffic. There's a lot of things you'd monitor with Nagios XI, a lot of services, a lot of ways it can run different protocols and services. So a lot of them can be found in this wizard. So there's tons of wizards for everything you can possibly imagine. So right now I'm just going to configure a Linux server wizard, but if you take a look and scroll through, there's tons of stuff here. So I'm choosing my IP address, the OS is CentOS. Those are the clients you're going to be installing on the Linux side so you can monitor system performance. And here is when the client sends data back to the server that's for the services being monitored, like swap, number of users, disk space usage, which services it wants to monitor. So when it's sending data back, it's knowing what to collect. So it's knowing what to expect and what to go check for and collect on the server and to display that it's being monitored. So I'm going to say check the host every 5 minutes. I'm selecting the default options here. I wouldn't make these numbers too high because you don't want to put too much of a load on your server. You can select if anyone gets paged, which one belongs to a parent. So, and then it gives you one last chance to download your agent. So again, we're selecting our Linux server. We chose HTTP service to monitor, and we're saying we want to check this every few minutes. I didn't select anyone to get paged, but I should later on. I could come back here and change it. So right here is showing everything by default, and the extra one I selected was Apache Web Services for the services being checked. So again, either like the ping, obviously doesn't need the client, but to check how many open files, the memory usage, and CPU stats, it's going to really need to go into the client and collect that. So it's using, you need to install the Linux client plugin. And I'll put a link here for a tutorial on how to do that as well. So now if you just wait a few minutes, everything comes back as okay. So it's checking our services. So it's showing right now that everything's okay. So now we want to add a new service. So we're checking if our HTTP daemon is running, but now we want to check if the content of the page is correct.
So I'm going to put up a very basic web page on my Linux client, my Linux server that's being checked here, my 1.31 host. And now I want to check the content, right? Not just that the process is running. So we're going to go back to our wizards. And there's going to be a wizard. And if you click on the little planet right here, it's kind of like it's going to show you just the web wizards. You can scroll down and go down to like kind of the web services and the web wizards that you can use to help guide you through this configuration. And again, you see tons of stuff here. MySQL, Oracle, MariaDB, printers. You want to check your SLOs to make sure you're meeting your service level agreements. Again, so here's our website defacement. Monitor website. So this is kind of flexible. And I'll show you where you can configure it. So first you put in the host name or IP address you want to monitor. Then we give it a prefix for, and this is just to help show where which server this is coming from or which page you want to look at. So it's kind of just giving you a service name prefix. So if you're monitoring a lot of pages on the same host, for example, you might want to give them all the same prefix. And then we have our IP address. It's showing us we're using, you select port 80 or 443 for HTTPS or unencrypted. And then if you need any sort of credentials to log into the page, you can put that here. So I'm not using any credentials for our main page. It doesn't require any sort of authentication. So I'm just going to delete that and leave that blank. Now here you can put a list of words you want to monitor. So if you want to put a customized list, you can. Or if you click these little check boxes down here, it's going to help you automatically populate. And you notice like pharmaceuticals and profanity and marketing and gambling. Those are like some of the key things you'll see on comments and blogs for unsolicited. I think it's referred to as malvertising. I just saw this. It's between malware and advertising. So malvertising their services and products. So it's going to load a whole bunch of preset words in there. You can scroll through it. You can add to it. And this is interesting. You can add a regular expression. So maybe later on I'll do another video on regular expressions and how you can use it for monitoring. But you could add a regular expression here. So maybe you could take the content and make some kind of hash. So if there's even a slight character change, you can actually monitor it with a regular expression and give it a name. So if you want to search for a specific string or if it meets a specific hash. Now I'm going to check if anyone should be get paged. If you want someone to get paged, if there is any sort of defacement, I'm going to add it to a group of hosts to be that's going to be clustered with just the services. And I'm finally going to apply my new configurations. You want to make sure you apply this. It doesn't won't show up and won't start getting monitored until you actually hit that apply. So now once we're done, we go and look take a look at our status for our client. Initially, it's going to say pending, you know, waiting for services to start sending information back. So it's pending. And then after a few minutes, we can go back in and take another look. And it still says pending, but it will come back as okay status. So yeah, it just takes a few minutes for it to check in and eventually comes back and gives us basic information about the main page that it's okay. Got a 200 HTTP code, which means everything's fine. Message received, a page received, page sent. So once it does that, we know everything's working correctly. Then I'm going to go in into my page and I'm going to go ahead and add defacement so you'd see how it's going to change. So here's my main page. I made pretty basic and I just created this using Dreamweaver and I'm going to load it onto my Linux server. It's also running HTTP, so it's running Apache web services. And I'm going to load it into the folder on the system that is where the main page files are kept and hosted from. So it's going to be var www.html, I believe, that will keep the files and store the files in this location on the web server to present it here as the main page. So I have my index.html and I have a CSS file. And now this page can get compromised. by being hacked. So if they got through some sort of exploit like shell shock or any clever exploit that will allow them some privilege or escalated shell access on the system, they can go in there and modify the main page for my Linux server here on my Linux server. The other way defacement can happen is if this was a forum, like a guest book, where it expects people to register, or some don't even require registration, just put in a comment and maybe their name or email address and submit, and it's going to take that and post it on the page. Now, a lot of people take that opportunity and put advertisements for medication or pharmaceuticals or gambling and try to malvertise, right? I think I just learned this term recently. It's a mix between malware and advertising, malvertise their product. So you're there trying to protect it. So once you're able to determine how you're going to need to protect it and what you should be monitoring for, if it's like a hack or malvertising, either drugs or pharmaceuticals or gambling, then you can kind of figure out how to do that. And again, you can use that regular expression, do some kind of hashes that will monitor all content. So even just one byte changes, doesn't matter if it's a comment or not. And this is better for static sites, I would say, if you do a hash. I wouldn't do that on a site that takes in comments that you know and expect it to change regularly. So here it is. So here it's still viewing it as okay status. Let's go ahead and add some defacement on my page. So I added, you've been hacked. I have your data. Give 12 Bitcoins. So the Bitcoins are pretty pricey right now, like a few, like $500 or so, I think. So yeah, so 12 Bitcoins, it is quite a bit, so, but I'm asking for $6,000. So I'm going to try to force an immediate check on my defacement on the page. And it comes back, it has critical pattern found. So from the keyword list, it was able to find something on that site that flagged it. And it's able to let you know that something on that site is now violating the list of keywords you submitted and what should be checked for. So something on the site is violating that. So now it's HTTP critical, and you know it's time to take a look at your main site and see what on the site has been added that's causing this sort of error message. So you could also take a look at the status on the services, the host services site, and looking at, and if you click on it, get more, some more details, and it will remain critical until someone goes in and modifies the main page from where it was defaced.
Thanks for watching, guys. I hope this is helpful. I'll see you guys next time, and make sure your SysAdmGirl sites aren't getting defaced. Bye.